New Israel, 6 New Israel government set to unseat Netanyahu, but when? So, this is really Lapid and Bennett. Those definitely were the head of this government. And good question. So let us see now, very interesting table about it. Also very significant, as you see yourself, as it comes in really very, very small area and many, many words, which make it very, very significant. This is, by the way, the people who are supposed to be in the government. You can see Bennett and Lapid, and you see Gantz, and Ivet Lieberman, all of them, yeah. So let us see what the Torah says, which is the blueprint of creation, about this government. So what we see here, and all what you see here, are really words connected, as you see Lieberman, government, all those words are related, and all of them come in one book, which is A is Deuteronomy, and in one chapter, even not in the full chapter, it is only for 15, the verse 15 to verse 45. So in 30 verses, you see so many verses which are all connected. So what are the verses? So I was looking for government in Hebrew, Memshal, you can see in blue, Memshal. And then Lieberman, you can see Lieberman there, Lapid, Gantz. Now the most interesting is definitely the appearance of Minut. In Hebrew, it is people who not believe, yeah. As what you call atheism. People really who don't believe, don't keep the Torah, don't believe in Shabbat and all these things. So in Hebrew it's called Minut. So let us see now what more we have here, which is unbelievable. As in a small area you have all these things. So as I said, we have here Lieberman. You have Gantz, you have Lapid, and you have here Memshal government, as you said. Then you have here, this year, by the way, it is very interesting, in black you could see Betav Shin Pe Aleph in 5781, which is 2021, unbelievable. Then you see also the first name of Lapid, Yair Lapid. And Meretz is a very leftist party in Israel, you know, Meretz. But we see a lot of dangers as this appearance of all those verses are in chapter 28 in Deuteronomy, which is a chapter of the curses. There are 98 curses that will come on Israel if they will not keep the Torah, which is written. As is written, "Ki lo shamata bekol Hashem Elokecha," if you don't listen to keep the laws and statutes of the Torah, so ba'olecha kol ha'olah, the curses. Interesting, this chapter, this portion, this chapter we read just before the Holocaust. Unbelievable, because it's came, because Jews did not keep the Torah. Now what you have here in yellow is very interesting. This is Erev Rav, Erev Mixed Mitzvot Yod. Because those are people who are going to rule Israel and people who are not keeping Torah, yeah, exactly what we have today. And this is exactly the sign before Messiah, because it's written that the ruler before Messiah will be anti-religious, will be against the religious, Minut, yeah, atheism. Then, so interesting is you have here the evil force of early. The Lilith, which is really the evil angel of lust. And this is really, unfortunately, which is the source of our troubles, not keeping the Torah, overcoming the Torah, and especially the Sabbath, and matter of immorality between man and woman, which is not kept properly. But what is the great comfort in this table, as our rabbis tell us, in Tractate Sanhedrin, that this is one of the signs before Messiah, that we have a government which is anti-religious, anti-Judaism, against the Torah. And exactly here come clearly, you see in black, Messiah. Exactly what our rabbi said. From this situation, Messiah will come. Who knows? Maybe it is because also here, by the way, there's a small left here. And who knows? Maybe the reason is because, you know, that doing things against the Torah, especially the Christian Shabbos, and against purity of life, men and women, this brings Amalek, this brings the enemies of Israel, Iran, and so on. And who knows if this will be the reason, yeah, that Jews will repent, will do Shuva, and then Messiah will come. Because no doubt that such kind of government, and, you know, against the Torah, anti-Judaism, so, especially Yvette Lieberman, you know, he said he doesn't want at all to have Orthodox people in the government, you know, he's doing all the troubles to Jews, Orthodox ones. So, no doubt that what the Torah says here, that curses will come if you will listen to, will not keep the Torah. So, interesting, significant table for our time, hoping the Jews will do tshuva, will repent, realize that the Torah is the blueprint of creation, and only keeping the Torah, the Sabbath, purity of life, men and women, bring us peace, tranquility in Israel, in the whole world.